heading to Guy's Naval. Now, regardless of whether you're going to the Underground Palace or you're going to the Witch's Castle, you do have to go through Gaia's Naval. So, we'll make that our destination. Prim is a little bit more efficient and useful in this game than she is in the original. Basically, it goes to the AI of all the command, the comrades you had. They weren't very smart. You had a sort of like a chessboard that you could move them around on in order to determine like their aggressive or their passivity or their like dodging enemies or whatever. But honestly, it didn't work that well. They tended to get either overly aggressive, like ridiculously aggressive, or they would be so ridiculously passive that they just couldn't fight at all. Oh yeah, great. Die! Randy, level 4. Makes it look like there's a road going to the left. Wasn't in there in the original game, so you could see what was in the original game on the map up above. I'm pleased to see that the companions have more intelligent acting, you know? Yes, kick this flower. For the most part, they didn't do anything until you took direct command over them and forced them to do something. Of course, you'd have to do that a lot for all of the boss battles. You would want to go and just take direct command over the companions in order to issue attacks, magic commands, all that kind of stuff. I imagine they won't do any magic until you order them to here. But it's nice to see if they will at least be better. Physical attacks. Now, of course, most of the time you're going to want to play Randy anyway because he has the highest, like, highest regular attacks. His physical attacks are the most powerful, and I think Prim's are, and then the Sprite's are, after that. So the Sprite has the weakest physical attack, but he has the highest damage potential on account of the physical attack magic. Prim has the second highest attack power, but her magic attacks are minimal, and for the majority of the game she doesn't have any magical attacks, but she has restorative of magic and some like supplemental stuff to like increase attack power, resistance, or whatever elemental stuff. And then Randy, of course, has no magic whatsoever, so he has to have the highest physical attack. But since he's going to be doing mostly physical attacks throughout the bulk of the game and almost everything except for bosses, you know, Randy's going to end up being the character you spend the most time with. Alright, let's go see what Necco Wafer's got.
This is Kipo Village.
Kipo Village. Yes. It's a village, huh? Oh yeah, there was a whole village, wasn't it?
To the north is a cave called Gaia's Naval.
Okay, I'm not gonna listen to that voice. Whole village of nothing.
My son Dylek always says he's too busy to visit.
I heard how rough life is in the new Viking.
Yeah. Where's the shop? There is none. All right, why am I here?
Welcome.
Ooh, elbow pad. Kung fu dress. That's expensive. I'm just gonna buy the chain vest. I don't think I'm gonna need a cup of wishes anytime soon.
Anything else? Come again.
Defense went up, and magic defense. I guess I could, I'm not going to upgrade Krim's equipment because she's not going to be here for very long. Then I'll pick her up again later. But that's going to be a little while from now.
Anything else? Come again.
Alright, Gaia's Navel, one of the more frustrating parts of the game, because it's sort of circular, like, multi-tiered areas where you're expected to loop around it a bunch of times. Now, if you head left, it's a little bit shorter than going right, or at least it should be. But the fact is you have to end up in Gaia's Navel multiple times throughout the game, and then progressing into the deeper parts of it. So you have to sort of run this loop a bunch of times. Same thing will happen, like a frustrating part will happen later on in the game. I forget what the area is called, but you have to cross it a bunch of times, looking for a certain stage. But, damn it. And you have to whip your way across a bunch of gaps and all that kind of stuff. It's a little later on. Gaia's Navel, though. That's the pain in the ass part in the early game. Of course, eventually we'll stop having to go here. Suplex that bee. Missed both of them. Oh, I've leveled up the stamina. Alright, get the sword back. Get it! Okay, once again, I don't like the rendition of the song I'm listening to. Before I go in there and I lose Prim, let's just take a look at those stats. Oh, damn it. Alright, strength. Randy, they're both the same level. So, whatever. She actually has MP, even though she can't cast any spells right now. He does have a significantly higher strength and even higher agility. Constitution's higher. Her intelligence is higher, and wisdom, that's gotta be the spell stuff. His attack is, of course, higher. That might just be because of the weapon he's using. Or no, she's got the better weapon. Whatever. A little bit higher hit percentage, higher defense, even though she's got better equipment on. Oh, you know, maybe she doesn't. Because I didn't replace her chest guard. Evades, a little higher. Magic defense, much higher. Alright, let's do this.
Where are we? this place has nothing to do with Dyla. I want to go to Elena's castle in Haunted Forest. Got it?
Yeah, you're not... We're not going there. What? What? Hey, hold on.
Hey, this isn't the way to the witch's castle. Where are you going?
I'm going to the
underground
palace.
You can go by yourself. I'm not going in there. So what are you going to do? Ugh, you're stubborn. Fine, I'll find Dyla.
Okay, they made that a little bit more complicated than it needed to be. I don't remember having to go in there twice in the original game. Of course, I mean, I expect some changes here. The goblin... Alright. Let's get a powerful attack on this guy. Oh, the blobs. Now, the blobs would multiply. And I remember the first time I played this game, I got stuck on the first blob. Fighting the thing constantly because it just kept multiplying. Alright, my attacks are missing. I finally did it. Because if you left one alive, it could just multiply. And when it would multiply, the new versions would have full health and everything. I ended up gaining a lot of experience when I was killing the damn thing, but it took me so long to kill it that I just ended up, when I moved on, my character had so little health and so little in the way of curative items that I had a real hard time getting through this part of the game. Stop dodging. I multiplied. It's doing it again. I'm having flashbacks to my youth. You know, I'm out of here. I'm not going through all that, especially with the camera running. I killed a kid goblin. It was a child, and I killed it in its sleep. How do you feel about that? I don't even let them bang up. Your dinner plate eyes. This turns into bones. What? Oh, balloon. I'm spaced out, man. It'd be cool if you could rotate the camera a little bit. I'm not asking for a lot. I just want to see everything from a slightly different angle. I'll get them that way. One more. How come that missed you? There we go. Money! I guess it can be advantageous to attack them when you're not at full strength, if you need to interrupt their animations or something like that. That seems to work for that. What's going on? Did I not need to touch the skull this time? Did you fall asleep that quickly? Yep, it worked. I mean... I thought I would have to touch the skull, or whatever. You're dead, right? Hey! 20 GP. Man, that lava friggin' just solidified real quick, didn't it? Aha! What's the mushroom doing down here? Of course, now I could probably have plowed through this entire thing without much in the way of difficulty, sort of like, how I'm doing now. Was there something over here? Am I just imagining that? And it's dead. Oh no, that was a door down there, wasn't it? The added mini-map is nice, I guess, because you're really not going to notice all of these doors, I think. Get out of the way! Or die, or whatever. Alright, yeah, here we are. We've made it. Oh, no. We've made it, but it's... We got something else we have to do. And there we go. I guess smacking with your sword gets the job done. Oh, my God. Settle down with these jumpy-ass tunes.